Hello and welcome to Greg Dixon's Comp 2 D2L Orientation Part 1. This is your landing page. Note on the right-hand side, this is updated last week. By the time you see this, it's going to be a little different. The news will change. But I'm going to leave the student video tutorials up indefinitely. Do check out navigation, course content, discussions, drop boxes, and grades. At the very least, every teacher designs their class slightly different, and their educational theory and the goals and objectives of the class they teach cause things to work a little differently between class and class. So a little bit of how it works for me. I will change this soon to give you a heads up. It'll be short information in the news. I'm not going to go into full detail as far as weekly lesson plan and expectations, homework. I did a little bit the first time because I just wanted to make sure people found things. I would like you to go to content to find things in the future. If you click table of contents, it shows you everything, week one, week two, week three. I'm doing things week by week because they tell me in EdTech that is the best way to do it. Okay, in content, I will talk to you next about how to access. Okay, this is how things go. Week three, this is all homework, you've done this. Week three is where we are now. This is what's coming up next we haven't talked about. At the beginning of the week, top post should be, read and says read first. This is a web page where it has basically my lesson. And I've explained a lot of things in my blog. I've done videos for stuff. There's a lot of links. I request that you look at them. Read what I want you to do. Alright, homework is mostly what you want to accomplish. I might be tweaking this, and I might be adding things. I'll try not to add any more homework assignments, but I might clarify, might provide rubrics, explanation, what have you. So if I do make a change, I believe there's a way I can alert you that I have made a change, and you can go check it again. Go back to the breadcrumbs, trail of breadcrumbs, and after you leave this is a Dropbox for the annotated bibliography due this week. It's everything you've read, citation summary, citation summary. If you don't know what an annotated bibliography is, I have described it somewhere else. It's in the lesson plan. All right, I explain things there. I remind you, a lot of this is repeated information. All right, you're going to watch it. Oh, and you are going to need to watch a video, TED Talk video. Create a reading log for this week as well. So we're doing, we have two drop boxes. Two assignments turned in. I want you to create both of your assignments this week in Google Drive. I'll explain more about Google Drive in a video capture soon. But back to content. How to access feedback. Go to drop. You have turned in, I have graded your literacy narratives, but a lot people are having trouble finding them. I'm logged in now as D student, and I turned in two homework assignments. So D student turned in two assignments for the literacy narrative. You go to the drop boxes. It shows you submissions, how many, and the feedback. You've gotten feedback. View the feedback. I want you to see what I wrote because I just did it quick and dirty to show you how to access the content using the material. You come here, click on the grade mark because I want you to see the grade where you get the feedback. So this, she turned in two papers. I started to grade the first one, but then I found out there was a second one. I grade whatever is the last thing turned in up till the due date. I won't grade anything turned in after the due date if you have something turned in before the due date. Okay, deadlines are important. Now, there are no comments on this one, but you can see how if you hover over these buttons, you can see it explains what the comments are. This is an awkward expression. This is a fragment. Now, some of you are getting some comments about missing punctuation, commas. I have learned after the first couple papers I graded that they give you too many. They want too many commas. I do not agree with them all the time. If it says missing comma, it usually doesn't affect your grade at all. Okay, hover over them to see what it says. Okay, that was just rude. But this is not a real person, so you know I'd never say that. Is it graded? I did. No, this has got zeros, all zeros. But if you click on this little Tetris thing, these square boxes, I did grade. Now, check originality, and I'd like you to turn things in early so you can check your own originality. And if you inadvertently copied something from the internet without putting quotation marks around it and giving attribution, providing citations to the end of your paper with a link to the source, well then, fix it before you turn in the final draft. I don't care. You can do multiple submissions for any Dropbox in my class. I only grade the latest, and I'm not going to bust you for plagiarism on an earlier draft. Doesn't matter. The latest draft before the deadline is what I grade. Now, in originality, you see, I commit any inadvertent plagiarism. This one obviously did. I wanted to show you that if anything you copy off the internet, it'll catch. So, heads up. Grade mark is where you see my comments. And I didn't put, I put a few comments. Some of these are stuck there by the machine. Eventually, students will have machines write papers for teachers who will use machines to grade papers, and nobody will have to actually read or write anything. Now, what I want you to do for homework, one of the easiest ways to see actually what comments were is to download the PDF. So, chose to open that. I'll save it. I've got it saved. I'll show you that in a minute. Oh, I did not type any text comments here, but I left a voice comment.
All right, Smilek, is this going to work? If it works, it might be really cool.
Yes, it did work. So I left voice comments for many of you. Sometimes my wrists are too sore to type. Some people may prefer voice comments. If so, let me know. Sometimes I leave text comments. Often I leave both. The rubric, again, is right here. This person, this time, D student, did a little better. Now, what I want you to do for homework to prove that you accessed all this information is to go back here. I just showed you download PDF of current view. Make sure it's the view is grade mark. There's three different views. Originally grade mark, and I don't know if we'll ever use peer mark, but we'll see. Make sure it's in grade mark. Download the view. Close this. Go back to your Dropbox. Literacy narrative. All right. And add a file. I want you to add the file you just downloaded. Now, in my computer, whenever I download things, they come to the downloads folder. Notice one thing I like about Dee's work is follows the file naming protocol. First name with last initial, period, abbreviation of the assignment, and then the date that it was done. She turned in two the same day, so she has number two, and there was a number one I deleted earlier. So, you click add a file. Click and drag, oops. There we go, upload, booyah. And then you click add this. Now, in the message box, when you upload something to a Dropbox, there's a room for a message. I typed a message. Here, I'm telling the teacher I uploaded that. When in the message box, when you upload the PDF of the paper I already graded with the format and questions and rubric on it, leave a message telling me, did you like the voice message? Would you voice option for giving feedback? Would you like it if you didn't get it? Does it bother you? Do you not hear it? Would you prefer everything written down? How do you like, what do you, about how to give you feedback, what works for you? Put that in the message. I won't actually grade that, but now I've got in one Dropbox everything related to this paper, and it shows, it proves that you access the feedback and you understand it. Now, if you open D student's paper, number two, it's kind of cool. It shows you the time it was submitted, word count. It shows these hovering things. I know what they mean. It tells you the score. A voice comment was left. All right, did you listen to it? It explains all those abbreviations. You probably don't have those memorized yet. Some of them are things I've written and added. Some of them, they have explanations. I added those. Here is the rubric. All right, if you didn't see it in the other place, it's printed off here. So, download your comments, feedback, upload a PDF of the grade mark of the comments and feedback to prove to me that you've accessed it, you can access it, because it did turn the corner for me. So I started reading instructor comments. All right, we're done.